time. It passes by, slipping away like water slips through cupped hands, like sand falls in an hourglass. Though the level on top never seems to change, you suddenly realize just how close you are to the end of the hour. Turn over the bulb, and with it, your life turns over. I know not yet where I'm going, only that once I get there, nothing will be the same. I'll be playing a brand new ball game, but at least I can turn the glass over again. Others have not been so lucky. Columbine, Orlando, the World Trade Center, Sandy Hook, San Bernardino, Las Vegas 2. Now this Valentine's Day, a shooter did enter a Florida school. 1,000+2 or more did he hurt, and at least 17 did he kill. Of course, they're just a few of the major events. You could name every tragedy till you were hoarse, and you'd never convey the extent to which lives are being taken away. At least I still have time, I hope, to experience life to its fullest scope. Whether they happen soon or far in the future, at least I can still look forward to my first kiss, my first dance, my first chance to form a long-lasting relationship with someone whom I can call more than a friend, and maybe to find some companionship with someone whom I will eventually spend the rest of my life, be it short or long, with, thus proving that love is more than a myth. And of course, my first job, a career, and accomplishments which for years will outlast me in name, although I'm not looking for fame. There's so much I don't know, there's so much left to do, but before I can go off into the world, I must say goodbye to you. With time ticking away, I simply must trust that whatever lies around the bend, which approaches as high school comes to an end, I'll be ready for whatever comes next, though I don't know of anyone who suspects that I won't be, besides possibly me. But of course, to be frank, I'm not gonna tank anything, except perhaps knowing how the heck I should say goodbye to you all when the time comes to part. Two poets once said tick-tock in this room, the room where poets and friendships both bloom. I want to avoid eliciting gloom, but I have to assume we will all miss each other. You've grown on me like sisters and brothers. It's so hard to end a poem like this, because I now realize something's amiss. I don't know what it is, but as much as we say we will all keep in touch, we always find ways with which to fill our time, focused on the present, tormented by the future, and with so few connections left from the past. Will this be any different? I'm the odd man out in camp message groups. I barely remember some old classmates' names. I don't want that to happen again. And so can we promise that when we all go off our separate ways, we'll all keep in touch with each other? Maybe even write poems like the good old days? And now to conclude, let me break the fourth wall. Do you think I could get a group pic of us all?